Hello, hi everybody. I'm Thekla Petridou, a Greek Cypriot psychologist, author, and YouTuber. And this is our weekly video in English. Today it's Friday, the 16th of April, 2021. This week's subject is about the absolute need we humans have for human contact. People, humans, are social beings. Either we like it or not, it is true that no man or no woman is an island. We've come to realize in the last year, due to coronavirus pandemic restrictions and social distancing around the world, how important it is for our emotional well-being and physical well-being to be in contact with other humans. Some things in life we take for granted. Some simple things like walking down the street and meeting people, going to a social event, to a wedding, a funeral, birthday party, or meeting friends for drinks, or going and dining out. All these things have been forbidden for the last year. And for people who are loners or social introverts, it's been a difficult year. I'm a social introvert myself. I'm an introvert, but when I'm around people, I am able to socialize, and I'm also told that I'm fun to be around or fun to be with. The truth is that every day I need my time to relax, to feel alone, and be myself. When the pandemic started, I was excited, really. I didn't realize that it would take for so long. And it was a very good opportunity for me to stay at home all day, to work online as I usually do, and not to have to attend social gatherings or not having to deny invitations for parties or for dining out, etc. But as the pandemic was progressing, and as social isolation was becoming not a choice, but something that was imposed on me, I started realizing how important it is, even for introvert people or people who like to be by themselves, how important it is to have quality human contact in their daily lives. This video is mostly about people who live alone, who are single, who live in a household of one, who are not married or don't cohabit with anybody, or they don't live with their families. They are old enough to live by themselves, and people who chose willingly to be alone. It's a valid choice. It's a choice that I go for, but in the meantime, we need to spice our lives with human contact. We need human contact. It's an absolute need for our well-being, our emotional well-being, our psychological well-being, and our physical well-being. So how do we make sure that even if we live alone, even if we are loners, we take some quality human contact in order to keep ourselves balanced? It's okay to take a decision not to be in a love relationship. Some people name themselves asexuals. They claim to have the sexual orientation of asexualism. I'm not a biologist, I'm not a researcher, so I'm not able to comment if there is such a sexual orientation or not, but in nowadays, people are allowed to name themselves whatever they wish. Asexual people, they say that they do not have any sexual desires, they do not fantasize about having sex with other people or with themselves, but they still need and wish for human contact. Even if you are asexual, if for any reason you do not want to have any sexual relationship, you still have the need for human contact. It's a valid choice for anybody, being asexual or not, to be single. Maybe you are going through a difficult phase after a divorce, or maybe you are trying to get in terms with your losses. Maybe you are in a mourning process of some beloved one leaving you, either physically or emotionally. Maybe you are at a time that you need to work on yourself, that you need to go to therapy to fix some of your issues. And maybe you don't even wish to be in a love relationship, but you really, really need other people in your life. You need human contact. We all need human contact. And because it's very easy for human contact to be toxic. I mean, there are people around who can, when contacting us, when communicating with us, when coming near to us, they can show envy or jealousy, or they can speak in a way that devalues us. Not everybody is quality human contact for us. And people who have decided to be loners, or who have found themselves to be loners, usually they come from family backgrounds that are not so positive. They've had maybe difficult childhood, maybe. Doesn't mean that who is a loner or is a prerequisite to be a loner is to have an abusive childhood. But I've seen it many times in my clinical practice that people who end up not alone, loners. Being a loner doesn't mean that you are alone. Being a loner, it means that you decide and you choose, that you spend most of your time with yourself and you spend quality time with yourself. In most of the cases and the psychological history of loners I've met in my clinical practice, most of them had abusive childhoods, but this is not a prerequisite. If we feel that being by ourselves is better for us, we need to spice up our lonely lives or our loner lives with quality human contact. We need to invest some time and energy in communicating with trusted friends, in having a small social circle of people that we have common beliefs and common understanding of life, and people that we feel that we can be themselves, ourselves with them. One of my clients was telling me that she's like 45 years old, and until now that she's on therapy, and of course it's online therapy because of the pandemic, she has found herself for the first time in the situation that she's able to talk about everything with me. She said, I've lived this lonely life for 45 years that I wasn't able to share my inner thoughts and my inner emotions with anybody. I couldn't trust anybody to talk about my feelings and to be myself around them. I couldn't trust my parents. I couldn't trust my siblings. I couldn't trust my husband. I couldn't trust my lover. Quality human contact is this kind, that you are able to talk with somebody and be yourself. It doesn't have to be a therapist that you pay them to be your trustee, but you can invest on finding in your life, in your social circle or your family surrounding, a couple of people that are worth to be deeply connected with. Deep, meaningful connections are the essence to happiness. This was also the outcome of the Boston research, the research about happiness from Harvard University, that people who have deep, meaningful connections in their lives are most likely to be happy and healthy. So there is an absolute need for human contact in our lives, but quality human contact. And here in our channel, many times we talk about toxic relationships, about intrusive parents, about how to get rid of toxic people in your life, and we say go no contact, cut these toxic relationships, but we have to replace toxic relationships with deep, meaningful connections with like-minded people that we can be ourselves with them. This is the most important aspect of a deep, meaningful connection, that you can be yourself with the other person. The other person can show empathy to you and you can truly connect in deeper level. We humans have the need to connect and share our feelings, our thoughts, our emotions with trusted people in our environment. So even if we are loners, we should invest on building deep, meaningful connections with people we can trust in our social surroundings. It might sound hard, but it's not. If you really make it a cause, make it a goal, you will be able to achieve it. Have a lovely weekend, everybody. Most hopefully next Friday, there will be another video in English. I'm supposed to upload a video in English every Friday, but some Fridays I do not have the time, but I hope that next Friday I will. If you liked my video, please share it with your friends and family, if you have any. Just joking. You can subscribe to my channel. Most of my content is in Greek. I upload only once a week a video in English, and you can see why my English is not as good as my Greek. Bye.